Hello everyone! In this video you can see the start of my learning journey of developing myself in using the Chili Art Bloom Technique. So all the videos of my learning journey will be added to the playlist called Bloom Series. And if you find that interesting to follow my journey, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to try to develop myself in using the Chili Art Bloom Technique. It all started with her. She made a course, an online course that you can follow. But after that, a lot of other artists tried the technique out and developed their own recipe. So I started watching some videos of Saskia Smit. She's a Dutch lady, but also Tammy Anderson, and they all revealed their recipe. So I've used the recipe from Saskia Smit, so I will add both their YouTube channels in the description box. Then you can check that out. So I start with a small surface. It are coasters of 10 by 10 centimeters. And yeah, let's see what I can make of it. So it all comes down to the base layer. They call it the pillow layer. Then the puddles on top of it, that's the paint. And after that, the last layer is the cell activator. And for each country, there are different recipes. So Tammy Anderson has one for the USA, but Saskia has one for the Netherlands. And I use most the recipe of Saskia. So for the pillow, I use the Histor bathroom paint. And experimented a little bit with it, but I got a lot of air bubbles in it, so I changed that recipe for the pillow. Now I'm using 200 gram of Histor bathroom paint, 25 gram of GAC 800 and 10 gram of water, and I added the pouring medium mix that I use for my bloom technique, and that's an acrylic binder and primer. So 90% acrylic binder and 10% primer. I made it a little bit thicker. And I added 50 gram of that to the mix I just explained. So I will put the mix in the description box. Then you can read it. But this will change over time because it's a learning process, a learning journey. So it will change. For the paints, I'm using Joe Sonja paints, and also this mix is from Saskia Smit. 50 gram of Vivid Enamel, that's from Color Art. I had a lot still here, because in the past I used it with the primary elements, and now I could use it again. So 50 gram Vivid Enamel and 50 gram Rust-Oleum Triple Thick Matte varnish, and I'm so happy because my associate Evelyn Schaefer sent me a can of that, so I can use that. And I also added 5 drops of Jo Sonja's polyurethane gloss varnish and 3 gram of paint. So also this mix I will add in the description box. I'm also going to use some interference mica pigments from Color Art. So 50 gram Vivid Enamel again, 50 gram Rust-Oleum Triple Thick Matte Varnish, and 1 spoon, the small teaspoons of pigments, and no Jo Sonja's varnish. And for the cell activator, also the mix everyone uses is 5 gram Amsterdam Titanium White, 10 gram Australian Flutrol, and 2 drops of Golden Fluid Titanium White. So that's the mix I'm using, but it will change over time for sure. All this information, what I just mentioned, I will put in the description box. Also, what I already mentioned, the link to Saskia Smit YouTube channel. She has a lot of great videos of the bloom technique. But also Tammy Anderson, she's in the USA. She uses other supplies. So I will also add her YouTube channel in the description box. So that's the information. I already made the first coaster. And this is my first try. So I'm really pleased that I got already that nice lacing effect that everyone is after. Now I'm going to start on the second one and then I will hopefully explain it to you all what I'm doing. So I'm adding the pillow, and you need a lot of that because you need to tilt your coaster, and the pillow needs to be the thickest. Then on top the paints in puddles. There you can see it. This is the magenta from Jo Sonja's Transparent Magenta. And this must be thinner than your pillow. Then an interference color. And I'm going to use the interference red. You can see it. So on top of the transparent magenta, I'm adding the interference red. And then on top of the interference red, I'm going to add the phthalo blue. And you can see the paint mix is thick, but yet that in this technique you need thicker paints. And the cell activator needs to be the thinnest. So, I tried different mediums, but the Australian Flutrol, works the best. There is an ingredient in that Flutrol that, activates the cells or the lacing. And the blowing is also a technique, because you need to blow in the middle and then in circles to the outside. And you need to practice this a little bit. There you can see it. And because you blow in the middle, the paint will get stuck on your coaster or surface. So you need to wait until that rise to the top before you're going to tilt your surface. So I'm checking if it's all loose, and then I'm going to tilt the coaster. There you can see it over the sides, very slowly. So you can see the paint mix and the pillow is very thick. So it takes some time. Yeah, and in this learning process, I will be using different materials. So now I've used this, but I also want to try other cell activators and other mediums to add to your paints. Because to mix your paints, you need to have a tintable base paint. But you can also buy a tintable base paint at the paint store. So you don't need to have the vivid enamel. Because I think you can also buy that at a paint store, where they mix your paints. So this is the second coaster. Looks great. I got some nice lacing effects. I hope they stay. And at the end of this video, you will also see a close-up after pouring. So I'm going to start on the third coaster. Again, the pillow paint. And this mixture has much less air bubbles, so I'm pleased with that. I'm starting with the phthalo green, also from Yo Sonia. So all the supplies I'm using, you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites. Now I'm adding an interference green. So in my mixtures, no water, only a little bit in the pillow paint, but in the paints, no water. Again, the magenta, very nice color. And on top, the cell activator. And then again, yeah, I'm so sorry that my head is in the way. You can't see me blow, but you need to blow straight down in the middle and then in circles to the outside. And now I need to wait until the paint, because I blow hard in the middle, is rise to the top, and then you can tilt your surface. And what I saw in one of Tammy Anderson's videos is that she blows on the cell activator and blows it to the outside to activate the lacing effect. So that's what I'm trying now. So for my first try, I'm very pleased what I'm getting. Yeah, and because you use a house paint, because the bathroom paint is for on walls, a wall paint, it can easily crack during drying, and that's why I'm adding the DHC 800, because that will hopefully prevent cracking during drying. And I've added the acrylic binder and primer that I use for my flower dip techniques, because then it will dry much shinier. Because a house paint that I'm using is satin, and I want to have a nice shine. So that's why I'm using the acrylic binder and primer, but also to prevent the air bubbles. Again, I'm going to tilt the paint over the sides very carefully. But all the information about the pillow mix, the paint mix, the pigments, and the cell activator you can find in the description box. But what I already mentioned, it will change over time. Because I also want to try out other mediums. Yeah, and this one is great. It looks very nice. You can't see the interference just yet. I hope to show you that in the close-up. But it already sparkles a lot. And this is so exciting to do. It's totally new, and it's, yeah, I don't know why you get these effects. It's a chemical reaction, I think. But all the insides I don't have. So the last coaster. Again, the pillow first. And you need a thick layer of that. Because the puddles you add on top, what I'm doing now, needs to glide over your pillow. So not sink to the bottom, to your surface, but yeah, needs to glide over the pillow when you tilt your surface. This is the Interference Gold. A little bit of the Phthalo Blue. And then the Interference Blue. And the Phthalo Green. And then the Cell Activator. And again, I'm going to blow straight down in the middle and then to the outside. Yeah, so thank you so much, Saskia and Tammy, for revealing your receipt to create these nice bloom in acrylic. And I hope I can also try this technique on a larger canvas. But first, I'm starting small because it's all about learning and seeing what kind of effects I'm getting. Again, I'm going to start to tilt very slowly because you can see it already in the middle that it's stuck to my surface. So, and if you tilt, then your whole design will get ruined. So it needs to get loose from your surface. So you have to need some patience for this technique. This one is really nice. Such nice effects. This can be some really beautiful coasters. And with a resin layer on top, I think the colors will be much beautiful then. So I hope you find this new series, the Bloom series, interesting to follow in my journey of developing myself in this technique. Because it's all new, but it's very pretty. What I saw from Saskia and Tammy, they made some beautiful blooms. I'm tilting it to the middle. And this is my fourth coaster. I'm so pleased with the outcome. I hope they dry very well. But the dried results you will see all in another video. if I made more of the blooms, then you will see them all together. I'm also working on a dried result video of all the the flower dips I made. So these were my first four tries to make a nice bloom on a coaster. And I think they look pretty. So let me know what you think of it. And in the comments below this video. So this is a better close-up in the daylight. And then you can see hopefully the sparkle of the interference. There you can see already the interference gold. Very nice, some nice effects. This was the first coaster I made. This one is also very pretty. Such nice effects. I hope they dry okay. So if you find it interesting to follow me on this journey to use the Chili Art bloom technique, consider to subscribe, give me a thumbs up for this video, that will help my channel a lot. All the materials I've used in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites. And I will also add a YouTube channel of Saskia Smit and Tammy Anderson, because Tammy Anderson uses other supplies that you can buy in the USA. But I also will add the paint mix I use, the pillow mix, pigments, cell activator, all that information I will add in the description box. Then you can read it there. But what I already said, that will change over time. But for now, this works for the coasters. And hopefully I will make this also on a larger canvas. That would be great. And with these nice effects. So I'm very pleased with the outcome. Again, let me know what you think of it. And in the comments below this video, there is a lot of information in the description box. Please check it out. And I will all see you in the next video. Bye.